It was the best of Macs, it was the worst of Macs. Today on PC Mag, it's a tale of two MacBooks. M3 MacBooks, that is. Apple has two MacBook laptops with the M3 processor, the 13-inch MacBook Air and the 14-inch MacBook Pro. One is bigger than the other, but if both have the M3 chip inside, then how are they different, really? I'm Joe Osborne for PC Mag, and this is which M3 MacBook you should buy. Let's start this comparison with what you can see in front of you. The M3 MacBook Air has a 13.6-inch screen, whereas the M3 MacBook Pro has a 14.2-inch display. Pretty close in size. Naturally, the Air is smaller and thinner than the Pro, but not by nearly as much as you might expect. The M3 MacBook Air measures just 0.44 inches thick and weighs 2.7 pounds, while the M3 MacBook Pro comes in at barely thicker and heavier, 0.61 inches and 3.4 pounds respectively. That difference might be tough to feel out, but you'll definitely notice the difference in performance under certain circumstances. More on that in a bit. Here's the takeaway. If you're dead set on portability, then the MacBook Air is the obvious choice. Just be aware that you shouldn't let size and weight hold you back from the performance you need, because you'll feel little to no difference between the two M3 MacBooks in your backpack. Now, what does that minor difference in size and weight mean for you? Both the M3 MacBook Air and M3 MacBook Pro use Apple's latest chassis design, which at these sizes has room for two Thunderbolt 4 ports, the MagSafe power connector, and a headphone jack. However, the Pro model gains a bit from that added thickness, an SD card reader and an HDMI out port. These two ports were clamored for by fans for years after disappearing for a time, and they came back with Apple's latest MacBook design revision back in 2021. Because the MacBook Air is focused on portability first, it's too thin to house more ports than those two Thunderbolt 4 connections. At least the latest Thunderbolt standard is hugely versatile, including multi-display and charging support, and it doesn't take up a charging slot either. Speaking of multi-display support, Apple's entry-level MacBooks can now output to two connected displays at up to 5K resolutions and 60 Hz refresh rate. However, both laptops need to be closed to do this. The MacBook Pro models with the M3 Pro and the M3 Max processors do not have to worry about this. M3 is powerful, but M3 and M3 Max are way more so. Sticking with the differences you can see, the M3 MacBook Air and M3 MacBook Pro are quite different in the screens that they've been built with. Both displays are Apple Liquid Retina panels, which essentially means that they're above 1080p HD in resolution. They also both display the wide color P3 gamut, which is essential for visual media work, and they both have Apple's True Tone technology. This automatically adjusts the screen color temperature to match with ambient light. This is where the similarities between these two MacBook displays end. The MacBook Pro, however, actually has a Liquid Retina XDR mini LED display, the XDR standing for Apple's Extreme Dynamic Range. Apple says this is a leveled up version of High Dynamic Range, or HDR, found in many premium laptops, which in either case increases contrast and brightness in images as they are sent to the display from the processor. Naturally, the MacBook Pro display is sharper too, at 3024 by 1964 pixels. That XDR tech helps this MacBook screen shine at up to 1000 nits standard and as much as 1600 nits when displaying HDR content. But the MacBook Pro display has one more trick in its bag, a higher adaptive refresh rate of up to 120 Hz. This is useful in video editing as well as gaming. Now for the really fun part, the speeds and feeds. While it's true that both the latest entry-level MacBook Air and MacBook Pro use the same M3 processor, it's not completely identical in both machines. The M3 processor comes in two flavors from Apple, one with 8 CPU cores and 8 GPU cores, and another with 2 more GPU cores for a total of 10. Both of these processors are available in MacBook Air configurations, but the cheapest Air model starts with the most basic version of the M3 chip available. The MacBook Pro, however, starts out of the gate with the M3 chip that has 10-core graphics, which is likely helpful in powering its higher screen resolution and refresh rate. Now, the MacBook Air we reviewed and tested had this optional 10-core GPU, but that didn't help it much in benchmark comparisons with the MacBook Pro. Why? It all comes down to cooling. The MacBook Air and MacBook Pro employ different cooling methods based on their system sizes. Because it's just so thin and light, the MacBook Air has no cooling fans inside, instead relying on a passive cooling system using heat sinks and other methods to naturally move the heat generated by the M3 chip as it performs. The MacBook Pro, while just barely thicker and heavier, is that way in part because it needs room to push that M3 chip as far as it can go. Even in 2024, the leading way to do that is with cooling fans. That's why you'll notice small vents in the metal chassis on each side of the MacBook Pro to actively push hot air away from the processor. These differences played out both in the benchmarks and in how fast the two systems felt in testing. The MacBook Pro encoded a 4K video down to 1080p resolution, a whole minute faster than the MacBook Air. Meanwhile, it beat the Air Cinebench score by more than 1,000 points. Playing games on both systems also made the cooling difference crystal clear. While I had to bring Baldur's Gate 3 down to 1200p resolution in both cases to make it playable, I could see myself finishing the campaign on the MacBook Pro with decent detail and just below 60 frames per second. However, the Air couldn't muster a frame rate above what felt like 30 frames per second with minimum detail settings. Fan cooled or not, you can expect largely the same battery life out of both the M3 MacBook Air and M3 MacBook Pro. This is because the Pro splits the difference between its larger and sharper screen and that of the Air with a larger battery inside. In our battery video rundown test, the MacBook Air lasted 21 hours and 38 minutes to the MacBook Pro's 22 hours and 14 minutes. The choice of which M3 MacBook to buy is an important one because of the price differences. As always, the 13-inch MacBook Air starts at $1099 for a basic M3 processor with an 8-core GPU, 8GB of unified memory, and a 256GB solid-state drive. The MacBook Pro, however, starts at $1599 for the M3 chip with an upgraded 10-core GPU, 8GB of memory, and a 512GB SSD. If budget isn't an issue and you don't have a specific use case in mind, then sure, the MacBook Pro is the better choice. Of course, it isn't that way for most people. To put a bow on it, the MacBook Air is the best choice for general users or students who don't have intense computing workloads, whereas the MacBook Pro can work a little harder for content creators, students with high intensity computing needs, and anyone who wants to play games on their MacBook, at least on the side. With that, go forth and buy the MacBook of your dreams, and no more than you need. For PC Mag, I'm Joe Osborne. Thanks for watching.